Hi guys, welcome to the second video of AI automation with Zapier. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can create a chatbot with your own custom knowledge base. So if you are a digital marketing agency or any of the small business and you want a chatbot on your website with the custom knowledge, meaning it's going to respond only about your business services and the pricing, then this video is for you, because in this video, I'll show you guys a step-by-step process on how you can create that kind of chatbot without any coding knowledge. So you can do that everything within Zapier, and you can sign up for Zapier using the link in the description. And before we jump into the screen, let's thank Zapier to sponsoring this video. Now, without further ado, let's get into the screen, where I'm going to show you guys how you can create a chatbot using custom knowledge base. So guys, I'm already logged into the Zapier, and now I'm going to click on the chatbots, right? In the first video, I've shown you guys how you can create a Zap where you can connect multiple softwares and create automation, right? In this video, I'm going to share how you can create a chatbot. So let's do that. Let's click on chatbot. Okay, from here, click on create. And now here we have option to create chatbot using AI and create from scratch. I'm going to create from scratch so I can show you guys step-by-step process, right? So let's name it test chatbot and then click on create again. Okay, here we have our greeting message, and here is actually the directive of the chatbot. So it's basically the set of instructions which we are providing to our chatbot that how you should respond, what is your style, and what are the other rules of your messaging and responding, right? Here we have this packet information where we will add our own company information. So I'm going to say you are a support agent for WebSense Pro, a digital marketing company. Perfect. Here we have this line which we updated, and other than that, I'm going to leave it as default. So let's click on save changes. And now let's move on to the knowledge base, where we will actually provide it with the knowledge that where you should get the information from. Let's click on knowledge. And here I'm going to select add your first knowledge source. And I wanted to read all of my website pages and then paste it here. Perfect. I have this option of crawl this link for all sub pages. I'm going to select this as the check mark and then click on continue. Now it's scanning all of the website pages, and you can see that it's giving all of this information here, the pages which I have on my website. I can select some custom pages, or I can select the first 20 pages, right? And I have a lot of pages on my website. So let's select a few of the pages from here, which is, let's say, select this one, or mobile friendly website, marketing. So these are the tags pages which I have on my website. Let's select some other pages as well. I'm going to scroll down to the bottom to see what are the pages which we have. So we have a lot of pages on the website, and I'm just thinking which one I should choose. Let's select this one. Let's select this one. And I guess that's it for now. So let's click on add six sources. And now it's reading all of the pages which I have selected. Notice I haven't added any code, nor I have given any custom coded instruction to this chatbot. All I have given is just a prompt, which was already ready for us, the instruction tab, and the knowledge base where I have just selected the pages which I want it to read the information from. Now let's give it a few moments to read the website pages which I have selected. Okay, after reading all of the website pages, it's now asking that configure knowledge source settings. So when the answers are not found from the knowledge which we have given, what is the chatbot supposed to answer? So here we have generate an AI response without knowledge source, meaning the AI model which it's using, which is 4.1 mini, which I'm going to tell you a little later in this video, will respond automatically. We can also add in a custom message. I'm going to select show a custom message for now, and it will say, I don't have this knowledge. That's it. and click on save. Perfect. We have our knowledge base added. We have added a custom message if the chatbot doesn't found the information from the knowledge base. We can also add additional sources other than the website. So here we have the option of add source. So if we click on add source, we can add it from a file, which we can directly upload, right? We can also add in from the Zapier tables. I'm going to create a different video for the Zapier tables. For now, just leave it. We can also add in a Google Doc. Here, we will need to connect a Google account. So if we click on connect account, it's automatically going to connect the Google account and we will see all of the Google Docs in our Google Drive. We also have the option of Notion. So if you are aware of the Notion, you can connect Notion account and pull information from there, right? We're going to leave it as it is for now. No need to add in more knowledge base. Here, we also have the schedule settings, meaning we don't need to tell our bot that the information which we have provided is updated. It's going to automatically pull that from the schedule which we have given. And here we can define the schedule. So here we have the monthly frequency, meaning it's going to go on a monthly basis on Thursday, every between 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. on the first Thursday of the specific month. We can also set the frequency to daily. If you are updating the knowledge base on the daily basis, you can select the daily, weekly, or monthly. It's completely up to you how you want it to schedule, where it will automatically pull the information for the chatbot. And you don't need to manually provide the updated information. You just have to update your website pages or the Google Doc. If you have connected, it is going to automatically pull the information from those sources on the schedule basis. Okay, let's click save and go with the default settings. On the next tab, we have logic. And here we have different options. So we can collect leads. We can add in the Zap button. I've already created a video on how to set up a Zap where you connect multiple softwares. Link in the description. And here, if you already have a Zap, it can basically trigger that Zap based on the conversation which is happening with the chatbot. Here we have the link button. So we can also display a button which will be a clickable button. And these are some suggestions for what should it do based on the AI, right? I'm going to go with the collect leads for now, meaning if it doesn't find the information from the knowledge base which we have provided, I want the customer to fill in the form so I can get back with them. So let's click on collect leads. And here I think name, email is more than enough. So I'm going to remove these extra fields here, but you can also add the custom fields. So if you want more information like text, email, phone, number, currency, date, link, all of these information which you can ask from the customer based on these additional feeds which you can add, right? And once done, it's asking when it should display this form, when to ask or when to provide this form to a user, whoever is interacting with the chatbot. We will select that when the chatbot cannot provide an answer, meaning when the chatbot does not have a specific knowledge, it is going to display that form. So let's select when the chatbot cannot provide an answer. And the style is embedded form. That's fine. Form title, please provide more information. Let's rename it that. Just a couple details so we can better assist you. That's fine. Perfect. Let's click on create logic. Perfect. We have our logic created. Now let's move on to the next, which is the theme. Here we have the option to add in an avatar. Let's upload one. So I'm going to add this fail icon as the avatar. Perfect. And here we have the embed logo option. Let's add in the same here as well, which is the official fail icon of the company. And here you can see that we have it showing up here. Perfect. We can also adjust the height here. We can also link the logo to any specific URL. In my case, I'm going to add this link here. Perfect. Let's scroll down. Here we have this again, another icon, which is an embed icon. So let's add in the same one there as well. Perfect. Now we can also change the shape here. I'm going to leave it as it is for the default. And below there, we have the option to change the color scheme. So currently we are on the blue, the default one. So if I click on black, you can see the background of the chatbot just got changed. Purple, green, orange, red. And we can also add in the custom color. I'm going to leave the default one for now. And perfect. That's it for these settings. Let's click on save changes and move on to the next, which is integrations. Here we can basically integrate this with any of the platform mentioned here. We can connect it with Slack. We can directly connect it with the messenger. So if someone is responding to your Facebook messages, it's basically as Zapier chatbot. We can use that as well. We can also create responses for incoming emails via Gmail. We can also create new Zendesk tickets. We can also build a completely new Zap from scratch, which is gonna trigger another automation. I'm gonna leave this part for now as it is for the default settings, and let's move on to the next, which is the AI model. Here we are currently by default set to OpenAI GPT 4.1 mini, or we also have the option to GPT 4.1 mini. And we can also add in our own OpenAI API key or Anthropic API key if we want to use a different models from OpenAI or Anthropic. Here we have the creativity settings. So if we want it to be more random, we can just basically increase it or decrease it if we want to be really predictable or less creative. I'm going to leave this settings to default and then move on to the next step, which is the settings part. Here is the public name. So is the user message placeholder. I'm going to leave all of these settings to default, and now we will see how we can basically embed that on our website. So here we have this share option where we can embed this, and before embedding, let's test it out to see how it performs. Now let's ask about company services. Now you can see that it's providing us all the appropriate information from the knowledge base which we have provided, right? Now I'm going to click on restart chat and ask a question which we haven't provided to the knowledge base. So I haven't provided the refund policy, although it's available on the website, but I haven't selected that in the knowledge base. So I'm going to simply ask, please provide refund policy. There you go. Now you can see that it's saying, I don't have this knowledge to assist you better. May I please ask you for name and email? So it's giving us a form. And when we fill up the form, we can then again add another logic to our chatbot. Currently, we have added a logic where if there is no information present in the knowledge base, it's going to give us a form which we created, right? So we have tested our form. Now we're going to embed it on our website. And how we can do that? So here we have this share button. I'm going to click on the share button here. And we have this public link where if you want to add it like in a new window, it's going to open that up on a new tab. You can see here, so we can test it. It's basically a complete chatbot in a tab. Now what I need is to embed that on the website. So I'm going to click on embed, and here we have these two options where we have pop-up and inline. So what I need is a pop-up where when I click on it, I'm able to chat with a chatbot. I'm going to select this pop-up and copy this script by clicking on copy embed. Now I have this WordPress website, a test website which I've created, and I'm going to simply go to dashboard and then click on plugins and click on add plugin to install a plugin on the WordPress website. You can add it on any of the editor like Wix, Google site, or any of the CMS. I'm showing you guys in the WordPress, but again, you can do on all other CMS as well. So let's install a plugin called post injection, which is for adding script code on WordPress. Click on install now. Perfect. Click on activate. And here I'm going to go to settings and then header and footer. Right. And here we have the option to add in the code to head of all on every page. So I'm going to paste the code which we copied and then click on save. And now if I go back to website, refresh, you can see that we have this loading here happening, and now we have our chatbot showing up here on our website. It's the same chatbot which we created. And now if I click on it and chat, it's gonna behave the same as we already tested. Perfect, you can see it's working, and it is working awesome. And that's it for this video, guys. Let me know in the comments below if you had any confusion. I'll be creating few more videos about Zapier AI automation. Would love to have your feedback. Until next video, have a great day.